name is Astrid Caldas. I am a climate scientist at the Union of Concerned Scientists, and I work with climate change and climate science, and I work with climate adaptation and climate resilience policies and climate impacts on communities on the ground. My work at the Union of Concerned Scientists involves communicating science to a lot of different audiences and a lot of different people with very different backgrounds. Of course, my main goal is to communicate information, true facts about science. But many times that entails clarifying misinformation and clarifying things that people don't quite have right. So there is a lot of advice on how to fight misinformation and disinformation. There is a lot of gut feeling about who you're talking to. You gotta know your audience, because I'm not gonna talk the same way to a scientist as I'm gonna talk to a community center or to high school students or to a faith community. They are very different things. I have to find something, an in, to talk to them about something that's gonna get their attention and that is going to speak to their values. So you cannot be confrontational, you cannot be a know-it-all. You cannot come across as saying, what you're saying is nothing, this doesn't mean anything, you're completely wrong. You can never do that, right? Always acknowledge, accept, and then you can counter, or you can kind of throw questions to the person to kind of make them think about what they had just said. And, you know, it's a conversation. It's never a lecture, it's a conversation. Connecting with people is easier than people think. There is always something that we have in common with somebody. I focus a lot on social media and digital media these days because it's a lot of people just get their information through those channels. The power of repetition in social media is unbelievable. People start seeing one thing 1,000 times, 2,000, 10,000, they start believing it. People tend to look at social media and digital information that is along the lines of what they already believe or what their peers believe. This is what people around me are saying. And so I'm going to look for the news that kind of confirms what I am saying. It's important that we use all the channels that we have. That's why I speak to the media, I speak to the communities, I speak to scientists, I speak to town halls, I speak to anybody, because it's extremely important that science communication is not compartmentalized. It has to be for all. My whole career, I worked as an ecologist. I studied ecology of insects, mainly butterflies and moths. While doing field ecology, field experiments, I started noticing that things were kind of amiss. Things were not going the way they had always gone, and things were changing somehow. Took me a little while to realize that was climate change. It was changing their life cycle, as we call it. It was changing the interactions they have with their plants and with their natural enemies. And everything was kind of falling apart a little bit. So at that point, I got very interested in climate change. I went back to school and I got a master's in environmental management and policy. And I left academia and I decided to work with climate change science and policy. I was a AAAS science and technology policy fellow in the year 2013, and I was in the executive branch. I work at USAID, working with the Feed the Future program. The training I received when I started my AAAS fellowship was particularly important for me to understand how policymaking works and how government works. The Union of Concerned Scientists, where I work, is mainly focused on federal policy. So to learn during that initial training how the government works, how people can influence what government does, both negatively and positively, and how stakeholders can be part of policymaking and lawmaking. That was really invaluable in my formation. AAAS prides itself in being a voice for science, in being a force for science. And I think that's particularly important to preserve the ethics, the integrity of science in policymaking and in everyday lives of just the common people, just the public, the general public. I think it's a very, very important channel for communicating science and fighting disinformation and misinformation.